the song that Guy wrote, as he used to say, on the occasion of his father's death. Guy told me that he had a hard time grieving after he lost his father. And he said one day he just sat down and he thought, I'll write a song and maybe that'll help me to deal with this, help me to grieve. He said it was only a song for him. He wasn't going to play it for anybody else. And then his wife, Susanna, she heard him sitting in the kitchen one night playing this thing. And she walked in and she said, "What is that?" He said, "Oh, it's just a song I'm working on, you know, it's kind of deal with my father's death. Said it's not really anything I'll play for anybody." Susanna said, "No, you gotta play that for everybody." My father had a Randall knife. My mother gave it to him. When he went off to World War II to save us all from ruin. If you've ever held a Randall knife, you know my father well. If a better blade was ever made, it's probably forged in hell. My father was a good man, lawyer by his trade, and only once did I ever see him misuse the blade. It almost cut his thumb off when he took it for a tool. But the knife is made for darker things. You could not bend the rules. Well, he let me take him camping once on this Boy Scout jamboree, and I broke a half an inch off trying to stick it in a tree. And I hid it from him for a while, but the knife and he were one, and he put it in the bottom drawer without a hard word once. And there it slept, and there it stayed for 20-some-odd years. Sort of like Excalibur, except waiting for a tear. We got back to the house, and they asked me what I wanted. No, I'm sorry, I messed this up. So we took his ashes out to sea, and we poured them off the stern. We threw the roses in the wake of everything we learned. Then when we got back to the house, they asked me what I wanted. Not the law books, not the watch. I need the thing he's haunted. Oh, my hand burned for that Randall knife there in the bottom drawer. And I found a tear for my father's life and all that it stood for.